सर
हाँ शुरू करते हैं 1 मिनट सरन से चल के।
हो सर
मैडम, वी कैन स्टार्ट नाउ, वी आर लाइव।
ओके सर, अ वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू वन एंड ऑल। आई वेलकम यू ऑल ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ बैरिस्टर शेषराव वानखेड़े आर्ट्स एंड कॉमर्स कॉलेज खापरखेड़ा, मायसेल्फ डॉक्टर संगीता चोरे, आईक्यूएससी कोऑर्डिनेटर ऑफ बैरिस्टर वानखेड़े कॉलेज खापरखेड़ा। एज वी नो, टुडे इज द थर्ड डे ऑफ नेशनल लेवल फैकल्टी डेवलपमेंट कम ओरिएंटेशन प्रोग्राम ऑन असेसमेंट एंड एक्रेडिटेशन प्रोसेस ऑफ नैक, a joint venture of internal quality assurance sale of santaji mahavidyalay nagpur, yashoda girls arts and commerce college nagpur, jm patel arts commerce and science college bhandara, dharampet mpdev memorial science college nagpur, mahila mahavidyalay nagpur, dr mk umate college nagpur and barrister shesharao wankhede college of arts and commerce khaparkheda. With due respect to the patron of all the organizing colleges, all respected principals, IQAC coordinators, faculty members, and my dear participants. On behalf of organizing colleges, I welcome you all and thank you all for being a part of it. Moving on, as we all know that UGC have made it a compulsion for every college to go through the NAC procedure, and hence, webinar like this helps us a lot in understanding the concept in a wider and specific manner, and also gives one a huge boost of confidence, knowledge, and significance regarding it. On the first and second day of the workshop, we were beautifully explained about criteria 1 and 2, and considering the same, today we are going to focus upon criteria 4, that is infrastructure and learning resources. Now I request honorable principal Dr. R.G. Tale sir for the welcome speech. Over to you, sir.
Good morning, everyone. Myself Dr. Tale, principal barrister Shesharao Wankhede College of Arts and Commerce Khaparkheda. Today is the third day of FDB cum orientation program. It is my great pleasure to extend a very warm welcome on behalf of my co-host. First, Dr. Vanjari ma'am, Santaji, Principal Santaji Mahavidyalaya, Nagpur. Dr. Akhilesh Peshwe sir, Principal Dharampet MP Dev Memorial Science College, Nagpur. Dr. Vikas Dhomne sir, Principal JM Patel College, Bhandara. Dr. Dhanesh Naik sir, Principal Dr. MK Umate College, Nagpur. Dr. Vandana Bhaglikar madam, Principal Mahila Mahavidyalaya Nagpur, and Dr. Dhanraj Shetty sir, Principal Yashoda Girls and Arts and Commerce College, Nagpur. I would like to extend my gratitude to our esteemed patron for giving us the platform to conduct FDP. A special welcome to the today's chief guest, Dr. Swati Madanwad ma'am, IQAC coordinator, SSBES Shankar Rao Chauhan Mahavidyalaya, Ardhapur, Nanded. I welcome to respected principals and all participants and all NAC coordinators to the national level faculty development cum orientation program on assessment and accreditation process of NAC. From last 2 days, we are attending very useful and informative sessions regarding NAC, and today topic is on criteria 4, infrastructure and learning resources. As we all know about, without proper infrastructure and learning resources, holistic development of students, Some people say the infrastructure and learning resources are not so important and learning can happen without modern technology. However, without infrastructure and learning resources, we are not able to good score and rise to the global standard. So we have invited a very renowned scholar and speaker, Dr. Swati Madanwad Ma'am. So detailed information and valuable guidance on criteria 4 will give by Dr. Swati Madanwad Ma'am, and we all will surely be enriched. I welcome her with great pleasure. Thank you very much. And once again, welcome to all. Now over to Dr. Sangeeta Chore Ma'am.
Thank you very much, sir, for your valuable words. Now I introduce you all to Dr. Swati Madanwad Ma'am, our respected speaker of the day. Ma'am has 11-year experience in teaching. She is first rank holder in MPhil entrance test in 2007, qualified SAT in first attempt in 2008. Ma'am has presented more than 15 research papers in national and international conferences. She has two translations published in Maharashtra government publication, translation of the historical novel Empire of the Mughal by British writer Alex Rutherford is accepted for publication by Sion Publication Pune. Now, I warmly welcome you, ma'am, to start your presentation. Over to you, ma'am. Dr. Madanwa, ma'am.
Very good morning to one and all. First of all, I would like to thank Principal Dr. Kale sir for giving me this opportunity to explain criterion number 4, infrastructure. And I also take this opportunity to thank all the principals of the organizing colleges and IKC coordinators and all the delegates present in the on YouTube format for this particular event. My topic is about infrastructure and learning resources, criterion number 4. And I will be referring particularly to this criterion question wise. So without wasting any time, I would just start my presentation. Yes. So infrastructure and learning resources is criterion number 4. It carries 100 marks. And as it is very implicit that for any educational institute, the proper infrastructure is necessary to perform it in full extent. So all the physical facilities, library facilities, IT facilities, and the maintenance of all these facilities are related topics or key indicators of this criterion. And this criterion has 100 marks. Criterion 4 is infrastructure and learning resources. It has weightage of 100 marks. There are total 13 metrics, and out of these 13 metrics, there are 5 QLM questions and 8 are Q&M questions. Now, first of all, I would like to explain what is meant by QLM question and what is meant by Q&M question. QLM question is a qualitative question or qualitative metric which requires a descriptive answer or response. There is a word limit for giving this response on the NAC portal, and that limit is 500 words for QLM questions. It means that your answer or your response to these metrics should not exceed 500 words. For the last metric of criterion 4, that is 4.4.2, the word limit is 1000. QLMs are part of SSR, self-study report, but these metrics are verified at the time of peer team visit. It means that there will be no DVBs on QLM questions. You have to write your responses in prescribed window following the word limit. following the word limit. And then again, you will also have to give the evidences, upload them or give them in link format. And this information will be verified at the time of actual on-site visit of peer team. It means that the QLM questions are there to be given in the SSR report, but this data will be verified only at the time of peer team visit. There will be no DVB questions on QLMs. So the first two questions are QLMs in 4.1. Then there are QNM questions. These are statistical or numerical data related questions, and you have to provide the numerical details or statistical data in the prescribed data templates. Beside, there is actual window of 5 years to fill in the details. After filling the information in specific window related to the particular QNM question, the system does the calculations and a score is generated. In order to qualify for the peer team visit, the institute has to score at least 30% marks in QNMs. Then while providing information, before actually starting to the question-wise description or explanation of this particular criterion, I would like to explain in how what are the different ways in which you can give information related to your institution on the NAC portal. The first one is the writing your descriptive responses in 500, 1000 or 2500 words, depending on the question in QLM questions or metrics. Then the second type is QNM, and here you can give numerical data year-wise in specific windows at portal. Data template is given to provide this information in prescribed format question-wise. Then there is the upload option, upload a PDF file. Here you will have to upload a PDF file, the evidences or information or documents in the PDF format are to be uploaded. Then there is option of link. PDF file is to be uploaded on the institutional website and link is provided on the HEI portal. And there is one more option, and that is choose appropriate option from the questions. That means question itself carries 4 to 5 options and you will have to select the appropriate one depending on your data. So these are the various types in which you can give your information on the NAC portal while submitting your SSR. So in detail, there is one more point we must know, that how to upload the particular PDF file. For preparing a PDF file, you first of all have to sort the necessary documents or evidences, then use highlighter to bring out specific details, proper attestation and seal of the institution, scan those pages and prepare PDF files. And these PDF files should not exceed the size of 5 MB. So this should be kept into mind while preparing. And this is one example of geotagged photo, that how while giving details of criterion number 4 and criterion number 7, we are asked to upload the geotagged photographs also. So it is a requirement for this particular criterion to know all these things of giving information on the NAC portal. Now I will start with the actual presentation, and that infrastructure and learning resources, this criterion has 4 key indicators. These 4 key indicators are as follows. The first one is 4.1, physical facilities. It carries 30 marks. The second one is 4.2 library as learning resource 20, 4.3 IT infrastructure 30, and IT 4.4 maintenance of campus infrastructure 20. So the weightages are respectively 30, 20, 30, 20. That means the criterion has totally total marks 100 marks. The first, very first matrix is 4.1.1 in physical facilities. There are total four questions. And the first question, 4.1.1, is about the institutional facilities regarding teaching learning. And the second question, 4.1.2, is about institutional facilities regarding cultural activities, sports, games, indoor, outdoor, gymnasium, yoga center, etc. The third question is related to ICT-enabled classroom. And the fourth question or fourth matrix is related to average percentage of expenditure excluding salary for infrastructure augmentation. So the first key indicator. The first key indicator, 4.1, is about physical facilities, and it has 30 marks and there are four questions. Out of these four questions or metrics, there are two QLM and two QNMs. The QLMs again are to be answered in 500 words, and QNMs are to be, data should be filled in the prescribed format in the data template and also on the in the window. The first question then. The institution has adequate infrastructure and physical facilities for teaching learning. I will read the question. The institution has adequate infrastructure and physical facilities for teaching learning. That means classrooms, laboratories, and computing equipment, etc. And the answer of this particular matrix is to be given in 500 words. Now, as the question itself suggests that it is particularly about the physical facilities for teaching learning. That means it is clear here that what is expected answer. Then again, the second point, second question 4.1.2, it is about the similar question is there. The institution has adequate facilities for cultural activities, sports, games, indoor or outdoor, gymnasium, yoga center, etc. The second question, second matrix is again to be answered in 500 words. I have discussed these two questions one after the other only to bring out to your notice that these two questions are similar, but the information which is required in each of these is different. In the first one, 4.1.1, you have to give the details of infrastructure related to physical facility. That means 4.1.1, yet is question mein aapko teaching learning se related facilities ke baare mein pucha gaya hai, aur the second question jo hai 4.1.2 is question mein aapko cultural activities ya sports games gymnasium yoga center inse related jo facilities aapke institution mein hai inke bare mein pucha gaya hai, lekin ye dono hi questions QLMs hai, inka answer 500 words mein prescribed window mein aapko 500 words mein inka answer dena hai. So I have discussed these two questions one after the other only to bring out the similarity and the difference. In the first question, you have to only give the details related to physical facilities, infrastructure and physical facilities for teaching learning only. That means classrooms, laboratories, computing equipment. There are three different words. First one, classrooms. Second one is laboratories. And third one is computing equipment. That means in the first question, you have to give your response in 500 words. And you have to give details of physical facilities for teaching learning. And it simply means number of classrooms and laboratories. And then you will also have to give the list of computing equipment. How many classrooms are actually there in your college, and geotagged photos of those classrooms. And then how many laboratories are there actually for science subjects or for the subjects like geography, and the geotech photos of those laboratories also. And again, the QLM must have a list of computing equipment. That means what type of equipments, what number of equipments are actually there, computers, for example, or maybe Xerox machines, maybe any other device related to library or laboratory, which is computing related equipment. So all those things are to be noted down, enlisted, and that list should be there in your response. So while writing answer to the first question, 4.1.1, the answer should be in 500 words. And the details of physical facilities of teaching learning, that means classrooms and laboratories and related facilities, should be mentioned in the answer. And along with that, you also have to mention the list of computing equipment in your institute. Then, while giving the evidences for this particular question, you are supposed to give geotech photographs of each classroom or seminar halls and other physical facilities related to teaching learning process. So it means that what one has to do, what we have to do, that we have to take pictures separately of every classroom, and these pictures should be geotagged ones. Then after getting all these, you have to prepare a Word document or JPG files and convert them into PDF format. And following the limit of 5 MB, prepare the final geotagged file and upload it. So while giving answer, while preparing for this particular question, what you have to do, you have to just prepare the list. At the same time, you will also have to prepare the geotagged photos. Then you will have to make a PDF file out of it and upload it. Apart from that, you can also prepare a separate upload file of purchase bills of all the computing equipment that you have enlisted in the answer of this particular question. And you can also scan the pages from the stock register where there is a mention of this computing equipment. So in this way, we can write answer to question number 4.1.1. Then the second question, 4.1.2, again is a QLM question. And as I have discussed that you have to write answer into 500 words. Here also, we are supposed to give the details of physical facilities. But here the physical facilities related to sports, games, and in that indoor and outdoor games, gymnasium, yoga center, or cultural activities related physical facilities are to be given. So while writing answer to this question number 4.1.2, all these details should be mentioned. Then there are some specifics given in the questionnaire itself, and these are details of size and area. That means while mentioning the sports facilities, you will have to give the details of sports ground and the size and area and all these things. While mentioning the cultural activities, for cultural activities there should be a cultural hall or amphitheater, or maybe some colleges use the seminar hall for that purpose. So the details of the year of establishment, size and area, all these are expected to be noted down. And the user rate, how many times these facilities are used. And then evidences in the form of geotagged photos of these facilities. So these were the first two questions, which were similar, and both these questions were about physical facilities. Particularly, the first one was about physical facilities related to teaching learning, and the second one was about physical facilities related to cultural activities, sports, games, gymnasium, and yoga center, etc. And while writing the answers of these two questions, first of all, prepare a data of all these facilities available in your institution, and depending on that, write a precise answer in 500 words. That answer can be written in sentence format, or it can be written into bullet form. That is the choice of the person who is writing those responses. And apart from that, there is also a list of computing equipment. And most important thing while writing answers to these questions is that these two questions are not verified in DVB. These are subject to on-site verification by the NACPR team. Then geotag photos is the most important aspect of fourth criterion, because whatever facilities you are claiming that you have, those will be valid, verified and validated by the geotag photos itself. So these were the first two questions related to physical facilities. Then these two questions both were QLMs, and both these questions carried weightage of 5. Then the third question is 4.1.3, and this one is related to percentage of classrooms and seminar halls with ICT enabled facilities such as smart classroom or LMS facility, etc. Before moving on to the third question, I would like to summarize the first two into Hindi. The in the fourth criterion, fourth criterion is about infrastructure and learning resources. That means what infrastructure you have for your in your institute to facilitate teaching learning process and also the other co-curricular activities. आपके महाविद्यालय में कौन सी facilities, physical facilities, support facilities available है, इनके बारे में पहले दो questions में आपको पूछा गया है. पहले question में आपको teaching learning की process से related physical facilities के बारे में विवरण देना है, और दूसरे क्वेश्चन में आपको आपके महाविद्यालय में को करिकुलर एक्टिविटीज, स्पोर्ट्स और कल्चरल एक्टिविटीज, योगा एक्सेट्रा के बारे में क्या फैसिलिटीज अवेलेबल है, इनका विवरण देना है. ये दोनों भी क्वेश्चंस का आंसर लिखते वक्त आपको 500 वर्ड्स की शब्द मर्यादा का फॉलो करनी है. और वाइल राइटिंग दिस आंसर आप ये लिखते वक्त आप सेंटेंसेस में भी लिख सकते हैं और आप बुलेट फॉर्म में भी लिख सकते हैं, दैट इज योर चॉइस. बट वाइल राइटिंग दिस आंसर्स यू हैव टू गिव द एग्जैक्ट इंफॉर्मेशन, एंड दैट इंफॉर्मेशन शुड बी अकंपनीड विद द, और इसके साथ में हर फैसिलिटी का जियो टैग फोटोग्राफ आपको अपलोड करना है. तो वाइल अपलोडिंग जियो टैग फोटोग्राफ्स, यानी हर फैसिलिटी का, इवन क्लासरूम, सेमिनार हॉल, स्पोर्ट्स कॉम्प्लेक्स, वट एवर यू आर क्लेमिंग, दैट शुड बी photograph using geotag photographs, and those photos should be prepared into one file of 5 MB limit, and then you can upload that. So these are the first, ye pehle do questions hai. Then first two questions were qualitative metrics, that means these questions were subject to verification on the peer team visit only, not in the DBV. Then the third question is related to percentage of classrooms and seminar halls with ICT enabled facilities such as smart class, LMS, etc. So infrastructure doesn't only mean the building. Infrastructure means in your institution, what type of latest technologies, latest teaching equipment and latest methodologies you are implementing, and for those what type of infrastructural facilities are available in your institution. So this particular question 4.1.3 is quantitative matrix, and it requires number of classrooms and seminar halls with ICT facilities. So actually when you submit your FSR, or while writing the details of your institution on the HEI portal of NAC, you give the extended profile of your institution, and there you mention the actual number of classrooms. So that is already there. And again, that is asked in this particular question number 4.1.3. So here, what is expected? You have to give the total number of classrooms. आपके महाविद्यालय में total कितने classrooms है? कितने classrooms है? ये संख्या, और इसके साथ में इन classrooms में से कितने classrooms LCD facilities उनमें अवेलेबल है, वाईफाई या लैंड फैसिलिटी अवेलेबल है, स्मार्ट क्लासरूम्स कितने हैं, LMS फैसिलिटी अवेलेबल होने अवेलेबल है, ऐसे क्लासरूम्स कितने हैं, और कितने सेमिनार हॉल्स में ICT फैसिलिटीज है. दैट मींस यू विल हैव टू गिव द IT स्टेटस ऑफ योर इंस्टीट्यूशन, नॉट ओनली द नंबर ऑफ द क्लासरूम्स बट एक्चुअली ICT एनेबल्ड फैसिलिटीज, having the classrooms having ICT enabled facilities, that is asked in this particular question. Then So this question carries 10 marks, and that is quantitative question. And the data required for this question is number of classrooms and seminar halls with ICT facilities, then actual number of classrooms or seminar halls in your institution, and out of those actual classrooms, how many are the classrooms with LCD facilities, classrooms with Wi-Fi or LAN facilities, number of smart classrooms, number of classrooms with LMS facilities, and number of seminar halls with ICT facilities. Now, all these are asked in this particular question, which carries 10 marks, the weightage of 10 marks. And as the formula itself is given here, you will have to give all these details and in the data template. Now, I would like to show the data template also for this question. Yes. In the data template for this question, 4.1.3, percentage of classrooms and seminar halls with ICT-enabled facilities such as smart class, LMS, etc. It is to be given in this particular format. You can increase the number of rows. Room number or name of classroom, seminar hall with LCD, Wi-Fi, LAN facilities with room numbers, type of ICT facility, and then the third column has link to geotag photos and master timetable. So, while writing answer to this particular question, you will have to understand that this particular question checks what type of ICT facilities are available in your institution. And out of the total classrooms, how many are actually ICT enabled classrooms? There are so many options. That means there can be classrooms with LCD facilities. There might be one or two smart classrooms. There might be some classrooms with LMS facilities, there might be seminar halls with ICT facilities, the numbers will vary. But the information to be given in that format must have the room number. That means we actually give the room numbers to classes and classrooms and seminar halls. So that should be there. And then that particular room, what type of facility, ICT facility is available there in that room, that should be mentioned here. And that will be whether it is that particular room has LCD facility or Wi-Fi or LAN facility, or is it a smart classroom, or it is a room with LMS facilities. All these details should be there. And then the third one is linked to geotagged photos and master timetable. Again, in the question number 4.1.3 also, you will have to give the geotag photos. That means whatever you are claiming, that will be verified in the geotag photos themselves. And again, there is one more point, master timetable. That means actually which classroom is engaged by which class at which particular time. All these details are there in our master timetable. So here, the link of master timetable is to be given in the data template itself. So all these three questions, 4.1.1, 4.1.2, 4.1.3, were related to physical facilities and physical or infrastructural facilities. And first and the third are related to teaching learning. And in both these questions, you are supposed to give the geotag photos. And one thing can be done that the 4.1.1 itself covers all the ICT enabled classrooms photographs as well. So the same link can be given here also, or a separate link also can be prepared. Then to score maximum marks here, because in this criterion the number of quantitative metrics is more and the number of qualitative metrics is less. So DBP related queries might be more in this particular criterion. But to score maximum, if you increase the number of seminar halls with ICT facilities or classrooms with ICT facilities, then it will improve your scoring for this particular question. Then while uploading, upload any additional information, paste link for additional information, and upload number of classrooms and seminar halls with ICT facility. The third one is data template. I have shown you already. And the first two, one of them must be the geotech photographs. Then there is the fourth question, 4.1.4 in first key indicator. Yes. This particular question, 4.1.4, is about average percentage of expenditure excluding salary for infrastructure augmentation during last 5 years. INR in lakhs. That means amount should be given in lakhs. Then the required data for this answer is expenditure for infrastructure augmentation, total expenditure excluding salary, and the percentage will be drawn out of that. So here in the manual, it is like this. Expenditure on infrastructure augmentation excluding salary year wise during last 5 years, and that amount should be filled in lakhs. Now when you start giving information on the HEI portal, at that time when you fill up the basic information, this window of years will be auto generated depending on the year when you are filling the information, and accordingly in the descending order the years will appear here. And then accordingly, we need to make the details. Before giving more details about this particular question, I would like to draw the similarity between 4.1.4 and 4.4.1. Just like the first two questions, these two questions are similar. This 4.4.1 is about average percentage of expenditure incurred on maintenance of infrastructure, physical and academic support facilities, excluding salary component during the last 5 years. Similar window, but here the data or the figures should be about the expenditure incurred on the maintenance of infrastructure. And the similar formula is there. Now, why I have discussed these two together? Because see, in the question 4.1.4, you will have to give the average percentage of expenditure excluding salary for infrastructure augmentation. Now, what is meant by infrastructure augmentation? Academic year में आप कई सारी physical facilities में changes करते हैं, नए classrooms बनाते हैं, या फिर कोई नई facility वहाँ पर available करते हैं. ये करने के लिए जो एक्सपेंडिचर हुआ है वो यहाँ पे एक्सपेक्टेड है. एंड देन द सेकंड वन इज 4.4.1, एंड हियर द एक्सपेंडिचर इनकर्ड ऑन मेंटेनेंस ऑफ इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर. सो एवरी इंस्टीट्यूशन हैज टू स्पेंड सम अमाउंट फॉर द मेंटेनेंस, रेगुलर मेंटेनेंस ऑफ द इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर, बोथ द फिजिकल एंड एकेडमिक सपोर्ट फैसिलिटीज. So that amount is asked here. So both these questions are similar, and both similar means interrelated actually, and they have the common data template.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Sorry to interrupt. Your presentation is not visible, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. Right from the beginning.
No.
Okay. Is it visible now?
Yes. Screen sharing.
Yes. Hi, yes, ma'am.
Sorry, please make it full slideshow, madam. Madam, please make it full slideshow.
Okay. Is it okay now?
No, it is still not full slideshow, madam. मैडम ऊपर जाकर स्लाइड शो क्लिक करिए, स्लाइड शो करंट स्लाइड कर दीजिए, दैट शुड बी या नाउ इट्स ओके मैडम.
Shall I repeat from 4.4.1?
No, the last two slides that you are dealing with, I mean, we could not see that.
The fourth one, fourth question was related to average percentage of expenditure excluding salary for infrastructure augmentation during last 5 years, and this amount should be given in lakhs. So here, the amount spent year-wise on the augmentation of facilities, physical infrastructure facilities. So that amount is asked here, and total expenditure excluding salary and the particular expenditure on the infrastructure augmentation. These two details are asked. So these questions have the same data template. That's why I am taking them together. So in 4.4.1, you are supposed to give the percentage, average percentage of expenditure on the maintenance of physical facilities, physical and academic support facilities. So here also non-salary expenditure incurred you have to give, and then you will also have to give the expenditure incurred on maintenance of campus infrastructure. So these two are interrelated, or they both have the same common data template. Amount should be filled year-wise in lakhs, and evidences are attested copies of audited statements, year-wise audit statements. Now, while giving the evidences for 4.1.4, you will have to take the audited statement and highlight the particular amount which is spent on the augmentation of the facilities year-wise. Sometimes it might be more, sometimes it might be less. It will vary year-wise. And then highlight that particular point, and then make five different pages to be scanned, and then prepare one PDF file for upload and duly attested, obviously. So this is the evidencing for this particular question. Similarly for question 4.4.1, have to take again the audited statement and then highlight only that amount year wise which is spent on the maintenance of the infrastructure, and then prepare a separate upload file following the limit of 5 MB. Both these questions are Q&N questions, and that means these are subject to data validation and verification. That's why while preparing the scanned copies of the evidences, you will have to check whether they are really visible or clarity is there in the scan version. Then, so these were the first four questions related to first key indicator 4.1, and one more question related to maintenance. And I have covered these five questions so far. So in criterion there are four indicators, and the first key indicator was about physical facilities. In the physical facilities, the first question was about the physical facilities related to teaching learning. The second question was about physical facilities related to cultural activities, games, gymnasium or yoga space, etc. That means co-curricular activities. And the third question was about ICT-enabled classroom. And the fourth question was about actual expenditure made on the augmentation of these facilities, teaching learning facilities and all the other facilities. And the last question that I have added here was about the actual amount spent on the maintenance of these activities. So the documents required were, for first two questions, there were geotagged photographs. For the third question, again the geotagged photographs and links to the particular master timetable also. And then for the last two questions, 4.1.4 and 4.4.1, these two questions, there is one common data template. One common data template is there. Yes. This is the one common data template, and that is year budget allocated for infrastructure augmentation, expenditure for infrastructure augmentation, total expenditure excluding salary, expenditure on maintenance of academic facilities. All these are asked, and expenditure on maintenance of physical facilities excluding salary for human resources. So these two questions I linked because these are sharing one common data template. And while evidencing, giving the evidences for these two questions, you have to upload the pages, scanned pages of your audited statements, highlighting the particular amount spent year-wise on first infrastructure augmentation for the question number 4.1.4 and for maintenance of physical facilities for the question number 4.4.1. So then I will move on to the next question. The second indicator of criterion number 4 is 4.2, library as learning resources. Here, the first question again is a QLM question, 4.2.1. Library is automated using integrated library management software. And this particular question is about which software is used in your library for automation. Then what precisely is asked is the name of ILMS software, nature of automation, whether your library is partially or fully automated, which version is there, and year of automation. All these details should be covered by writing answer in 500 words. This is again QLM question. QLM questions are verified during the actual peer team visit. That's why there will be no DBV questions on these. And this particular question should be answered either in tabular form, either in bullet form, or in a descriptive answer of 500 words. But it must cover the name of the software, nature of automation, version of the software, and year of automation. So while writing this particular answer, you also have to give the screenshots of that software, the landing pages, with whatever you are claiming, that will be justified by that. It will be verified actually at the time of peer team visit. Along with that, the evidence will also comprise of purchase bills for the library software and screenshots of landing pages of library software. Then QLM question it is, that's why it is subject to on-site verification by the peer team. Then there is the question. Then the second question is, in this particular key indicator, the first question was about ILMS software, which was a QLM question. That means answer should be written in 500 words. And the information which is asked here is about the library software. Evidences will include the purchases of that library software and also the screenshots of landing pages of library software. Then the second question is Q&M question 4.2.2. The second question in key indicator, library as learning resource. Here, the question is, the institution has subscription for following e-resources. And there are six options. The first one is e-journals. The second one is e-Shodhasindhu. Third one is Chodaganga membership, e-books, databases, and remote access to e-resources. Now, as most of the libraries have the enlist membership, which covers four out of these 6 points. And that means you should have the enlist membership. and the details of subscription and membership are to be uploaded in the evidences. Apart from NLIST, you can also give the access to your students and faculties to open e-resources. These can be availed on the website of the institution, on the library page, or on the library website. So that is also part of e-resources. But these should be open resources. Or maybe... For this question also, there is a data template. For this question also, there is a data template, and that data template is like this. Here you will have to give the year-wise. This particular data template is there. It covers both 4.2.2 and 4.2.3. Now, 4.2.3 is about average annual expenditure on purchase of books or e-books and subscription for journals or e-journals. Now, what is asked here is how much amount is spent on the purchase of books or e-books and subscription for journals and e-journals. So, this again requires the audited statement. What one has to do that year-wise audited statements, and only that much amount which is spent on the purchase of e-books or books, that should be highlighted, and those pages should be scanned and uploaded together in a PDF file. So for these two questions, there is one common data template. And that is this one, where you will have to enter the details year-wise. So this is again a question related to a question of statistical details, Q&M question it is. Then the last question related to library is 4.2.4, percentage of per day usage of library by teachers and students. Here the footfalls and login data for online access is asked. In this question number 4.1.4.2.4, percentage of per day usage of library by teachers and students, footfalls and login data for online access. So these are to be maintained regularly, and the total number of staff, total number of students using library per day, that detail should be kept, and that should be maintained regularly, and the ratio is to be derived from that. In the upload section, you will have to give the details of library usage by teachers and any additional information related to that. So this is again the question related to library. What data is sought in this particular question is the last day of session register details are to be uploaded. Then for measuring this particular footfalls, which method is used, that should be also explained. And also, if you have the software, then automatically the online access data will be generated. You will have to just download and attest it and then file that. So this is So these were the questions related to library. Second key indicator of criterion number 4 was related to library and learning resource, and it had 4 questions in it. The first question was QLN question, descriptive answer question, and this was about the library software, and particularly you are asked to give details about library software, nature of automation, version of software, and year of automation. All these details should be given, are expected to be given in that particular answer in 500 words, and it carried 4 marks. This subject was QLM, that means it was subject to on-site verification by NAC peer team. But while writing the answer, you are supposed to upload additional information, and that additional information means you have to give the screenshots of the software. Then, and also the purchase documents of that software. Then the second question was Q&A question, and it was about which of the following 6 you have actually, which of the following 6 e-resources actually you have in your institution. And it simply means that if you have English subscription, you have 4 out of these 6. And in the upload section, you are supposed to upload the membership details and the subscription details of NLIST. Apart from NLIST, you can also avail online open e-resources to your faculty and the students through links available, links provided on the website or the library page of the website. Then there was a third question, 4.2.3. It was about the annual expenditure on books or e-books and subscription of journals and e-journals. Now this question was regarding the annual expenditure of last 5 years about library purchase. And that that to score more, you must have this ratio high. And in the upload section, as evidence to this particular question, again, you have to upload the audited statement highlighting the library purchase details, and only those pages in your audited statement of last 5 years where there is mention about library purchase, highlight that, scan those pages and upload with your attestation in the limit of 5 MB. Then the last question was again related to library, and that question was about footfalls or login data. If the software is used in the library, automatically the e-access data is generated. Only that should be downloaded and attested and uploaded. And about the manually calculated footfalls, you have to maintain the register and then prepare the data and then calculate and then give the actual number there. But for evidence, you have to upload the last page of accession register, and apart from the last page, some randomly selected dates might be asked, and you can give more pages also. But this again is a quantitative question. Then there is a criterion number 4, third key indicator is about IT infrastructure. It carries 30 marks and 3 questions only. Out of these 3 questions, only one question is qualitative and the remaining questions are quantitative. The first question about IT infrastructure is, institution frequently updates its IT facilities including Wi-Fi. That means here in this particular question, you are asked about the IT facilities, whether your institution has which facilities you have and how these facilities have, there is number, increase in the number of these facilities during the assessment period. So year-wise, the details are to be given, and that answer should be written into 500 words. How many computers you have, how many softwares you have, whether you have a Wi-Fi facility, whether you have broadband connectivity, all these things and the details, the purchase orders, at the same time, the bills, stock register details, all these things are supportive documents. But the answer should be written in 500 words, and it should summarize the upgrading amount or number of the IT facilities. So this is expected in this particular answer. This is QLM. That's why it will be verified during the on-site visit. Here you can also give the broadband speed related screenshot. It is also expected there. Then the second question of this key indicator 4.3.2 is about student computer ratio, and the detail is asked, the data is asked about the recently latest completed academic. Now here you have to give the actual ratio, and that is number of students, number of computers in your institution. But here number of computers only used for the academic purposes are mentioned, not the computers used in the office or mainly given to the head of departments or etc. Here only the computers which are actually in use by the students, that number is given, is to be given. And here you can give the details from the stock register about the computers, highlighting the particular information and then scanning and uploading that on those pages only. And then you can also give the purchase bills of computers. You can also give the these details along with the geotech photos of that computer laboratory also. So all these things are expected here in this particular question. This is again a Q&M question. To score more, this ratio should be more. Then the third question is directly a question related to bandwidth connection, and you have five options. The score in the four marks scale will depend on this which option you are choosing. So it is better to have a good broadband connection. And then in the upload section, what is expected to be uploaded? The purchase order bills of this broadband connection and the speed related screenshot also. All these are to be uploaded. Now this is again a Q&M question. So the criterion number four, segment key indicator number 4.3 was related to IT infrastructure. It carried 30 marks, and here all the three questions were related to IT infrastructure, broadband and computers. And one question, the first question was QLM, that means you have to write the descriptive answer. And the remaining two questions were statistical or numerical details were asked, they were the quantitative questions. When you write answer to the qualitative question, you upload the information that is verified only at the time of peer team visit. You do not have DVV related questions on these matrices. But in case of the quantitative matrix, when you fill up the information, when you give the data, the particular formula is used by the system and you get the auto-generated score. So that you will get for most of the questions here in this criteria. And only one question is left, and that means about maintenance of campus infrastructure. Now, here in this particular criterion, there are two questions, but one I have already, so I will only discuss the 4.4.1, and the, this one I have already discussed. So I will only discuss the second one, and that is a QLM question. There are established systems and procedures for maintaining and utilizing physical, academic and support facilities, laboratory, libraries, sports complex, computers, classrooms, etc. Now this is a descriptive question and it has the word limit of 1000 words. Again, this answer, not only it should be uploaded on the website of NAC HI portal, but it also should be given on the website of the institution. It is clearly stated here on the website within a maximum 1000 words. So what is this question about? There are established systems and procedures for maintaining and utilizing physical, academic, these are two things, utilizing and maintaining. That means how you utilize the available facilities in your college and how you maintain those facilities. That means the these two should be systematically written down. There should be policies for this. Every college has some method, some practice, but that is never documented most of the times. So it should be well documented. That is expected here. And that should be about not only the teaching learning related facilities, but that should be about all the infrastructural facilities of your campus. So for this, there should be written policy, policy statement, procedures, and for example, library usage related, how you maintain your library, what are the rules for the usage of library, what are the timings, and how you maintain the library, whether there is weeding out, whether there is stock verification, and when this maintenance procedure is performed during the vacations or during a particular day of the week or month, like this, all these details should be documented. Likewise, whether you have, when you have to use a particular seminar hall or you have to use the ICT classroom, and what is the procedure, whether it is allotted always in the timetable, or sometimes the faculty has to take the permission also, and what is the procedure for that. All these types of details about utilizing the physical, academic, and support facilities, and at the same time, the details about the maintenance of those systems. That means, for example, if we are discussing computers, then how these computers are maintained, how they are upgraded, the systems are upgraded, whether antivirus is done properly time to time, what is the policy if any of these objects is damaged or it has stopped working, then how you replace it, what is the procedure, and what most importantly, if there are annual maintenance contracts done for all these utilities. So all these should be well documented and differently for different sections. That means for laboratory, what is the procedure, for library, for what is the procedure, for sports complex, how you use it, whether it is only for the teachers, for the non-teaching staff, or only for the students, and or you also allow the other residents of the town, or you also allow the alumni to use some of these facilities. And if you do so, then what are the rules? All these things about utilization and about the maintenance of these facilities are to be well documented, and they should be uploaded on the institutional website, and that should be written on the web HAI portal also. That is expected while writing the answer to this particular question. Now, in this way, this was the last question of criterion number 4, but before I conclude, I would like to bring out the point. I would try to summarize this presentation in a nutshell. It will take only 5 minutes. This particular criterion, was about infrastructure and learning resources. It had the weightage of 100, and then there are four key indicators in it. The first one was 4.1 about physical facilities. The second one was library as a learning resource. The third one was IT infrastructure, and the fourth one, maintenance of campus infrastructure. So all these are interrelated and related to physical facilities of teaching, learning, and other activities. Then out of this, in these four key indicators, totally 13 metrics are covered. And out of these 13 metrics, there are 5 QLM questions, that means descriptive questions, and 8 quantitative questions or quantitative metrics. For the QLM questions, qualitative metrics, that means questions, the response described word limit, mostly it is 500 words. In the last question, it is 1000 words. The information given in qualitative metrics is not verified during DBV process. It is a part of SSR, but it is verified at the time of peer team visit. But we have to provide the supporting documents and evidences in upload or link form. Then the second type of question was quantitative metrics, which means questions related to statistical data. This data is verified during the DBV process. You have to fill the details in prescribed data template, and a score is generated on the portal as response for this metric. It is only if the score is above 30% that the institution is eligible for peer team visit. Then, what type of documents are required while writing, while preparing for this particular criterion? I have made a list of those documents or evidences. The first one and the first and the foremost, most important thing is the geotag photos of physical facilities. First, for the question number 4.1.1, you require the geotag photos of classrooms, laboratories, seminar halls, and all teaching learning facilities. And then you require the geotag photos of cultural, sports, yoga, gymnasium related facilities for the question 4.1.2. Then the details of these facilities and their usage. Then you have to prepare a list of computing equipment in your institution. for the question 4.1.3, you are supposed to prepare geotech photos of ICT classrooms. Then you are also have to you upload the purchase bills of ICT facilities. Then there is at one question, in one question, there is a link to the master timetable is also asked. Then for the questions related to library purchase and the questions related to expenditure on augmentation and maintenance of infrastructure, you require the audited statements. And in the audited statements, yearly expenditure on augmentation of infrastructure, yearly expenditure on maintenance of the campus, yearly expenditure on purchase of books and e-resources. These three are asked in different, differently in three different questions. And these audited statement related details are asked year wise. So you have to just compile the audited statements of last 5 years of the assessment period and then highlight that particular information, scan, attest, scan and upload in the limit of 5 MB. Then there is the question of student computer ratio, actual number of computers in the institution which are used by the students and not the computers which are in administrative use. And again, this ratio is asked of the last completed academic year. That means also you have to give the C statement and actual number of students in that particular year. And then for the question related to library, you will have to give the details of the ILMS software. You will have to give the details of the ENLIS subscription and the purchase. And you also have to give the details of accession register, some pages from the accession register randomly selected. Then for library section, you can also avail the e-resources, open e-resources to your students and staff apart from the ENLIS subscription. And these can be availed on the library or institutional website. So screenshots of those links are also, you can also upload them. Then there for the IT related questions, for the IT facilities, year-wise entries in stock register about the IT facilities, broadband purchase document, broadband bills, screenshots of broadband, that means while using broadband connection, you can just check whether, what is the speed, that screenshot is there. And then policy document for use and maintenance of the infrastructural physical facilities in your institution, all those documents about use of the facilities and the maintenance of these facilities, these should be there. Annual maintenance contracts for various equipment and instruments. Then also the, you can also keep the bills of upgradation of systems, computers, and also the details of antivirus. Then details of stock verification, weeding out, etc. related to library maintenance. And also you can add the maintenance document of your website, because website is the need now and that you need to maintain it also. So that document can also be given here as a part of maintenance document. And the 2 points that are to be remembered while preparing this data, that PDF file limit for uploading on the NAC website or the HAI portal is that of 5 MB. Larger files can be uploaded on the institutional website and the link can be given in the particular answer. So this was my presentation. I tried to summarize it again into a gist or nutshell. And I tried to cover all the questions in criterion number 4. But it was very difficult for me to be very fluent in Hindi. So I tried to speak slowly and simply in English. So I tried to give my presentation. Thank you for giving me this opportunity.
Thank you very much, ma'am, for sharing valuable information to us regarding criteria 4 and explaining it in such a wonderful manner and dignity. It was really worth listening to. Now, we are going to begin with the interactive session. Participants can ask the question by using chat box. There is one question which is asked by Chetan Zawre, sir. Is there any standards or ideal dimensions and numbers for classroom and laboratories, etc., as declared? If yes, where we will get it?
I think that these details can be, as the question itself has that word, that these details are decided by the statutory authority, and the statutory authorities can be UGC or the university. From those websites can get that information. But generally, depending on the student strength, whether you have the actual student, the programs which are offered, depending on that, your infrastructure should be adequate.
There is another question by Prashant Ambikar, sir. What are the funding available for environmental awareness related infrastructure?
That question is not related to the criterion number 4, but that will be more probably covered into criterion number 7, which is again related to infrastructural details, but related to environmental things.
Okay. Thank you very much, ma'am. Now, I invite to Professor Jyoti Selukar, ma'am, to propose vote of thanks and conclude the program. Over to you, ma'am, Dr. Jyoti Selukar, ma'am.
I am audible.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Thank you, Sangeeta. Honorable Chief Guest, present dignitaries, and my dear friends, good afternoon, everyone. I am Dr. Jyoti Selukar, Professor and Head, Department of Sociology, Barrister Sheshram Ankhede, College of Arts and Commerce, Kharkhoda. I take this opportunity to propose vote of thanks on behalf of organizing committee. I thank our chief guest, Dr. Swati Mandanwad, ma'am, Accuracy Coordinator, Shankar Rao Chauhan Mahavidyalaya, Nanded. Ma'am, we are really enlightened by your presence and valuable guidance in a very effective manner about criteria 4, infrastructure and learning resources. Once again, thank you very much, ma'am. I would like to extend my gratitude to our esteemed patrons for giving us this platform to conduct faculty development program. I express my sincere thanks to principals and IQSC coordinators, all institutes, for kind support. The success of this today's session is incomplete without thanking to all the participants. So thank you all participants. Now, with the kind permission of organizing committee, I declare that today's session ended here. Thank you.
Thank you, everyone. And special thanks to Dr. Karthik, sir.
Karthik sir,
I'm closing the meeting, sir. हमारे पावर चले गया है, दूसरे एंड से कर रहा हूं मैं. Thank you, sir.